Efficiency fans, and welcome back to Munich, Germany. We're here on day two of Celonis' Celosphere. My name is Savannah Peterson, joined by my fabulous co-host, Rob Strechay. Rob, how are you feeling today?
I'm feeling good. I feel the energy of the guests that we have on. They're very excited. I think everybody may have been watching the football match tonight. So some people are annoyed, some people are not, but it's great to be here and hear the customer stories and about the innovation and where they're taking the product.
Yeah, absolutely. And speaking of innovation, we're going to be talking about saving lives and process mining with our next guest. Etienne, thank you so much for taking the time to hang out with us today. How are you doing?
Excellent. Energized by the atmosphere here at Celosphere.
Yeah, it must be very cool for you to be hanging out with the community of people who are also doing a lot of really exciting things. So, because right away when you sat down and you brought it up, I got to ask, tell us how Karl Storz saved lives and how you bumped in, or how you decided you needed Celonis to help you continue to do that.
Perfect. Let me introduce myself first, yeah? I'm Etienne, and I'm the head of the Global Business Process Management Department at Karl Storz. And Karl Storz is a hidden champion in the medical engineering industry. So we are a global leader in the area of endoscopy, as well as integrated operating room solutions and in the field of robotic surgery.
So I'm curious, just as you said that, you say you're a hidden champion? Why do you say hidden?
Hidden means for consumers. They don't know us. But if you are in a hospital and if you get an endoscopic laparoscopy, for example, then the chance to be operated with our instruments is quite high.
I can imagine there is a lot of pressure on the development of said instruments and making sure that you're ensuring quality, reliability, many things, particularly in that environment. I can't think of a more critical environment. What are some of the challenges that you work with your team on to try and ensure never, ever mess up?
In the end, it's about complexity and increasing complexity. We have to take thousands of things into mind when we manage processes and if we provide our products to our customers. We have to think about efficiency, effectiveness, costs, time. We need to deliver our products as fast as possible, yeah, because it's about expensive products, yeah. And of course, we have to struggle with regulation, with increasing competition, with digitalization, and with global supply chains. So it's an interesting field of complexity, and the question is, how can you be aware about all the different aspects to manage your processes in a sufficient way?
How do you, when you brought Celonis in, where did you start? What processes did you start with? Or you probably have been doing some process mining before, but bringing in the platform to really take it to the next level.
Yeah. I think when you implement process mining, the first question should be, what are the most important processes where we can leverage the benefit, right? And mostly, these are the processes in the area of operations. Order to cash, purchase to pay, make to stock, accounts payable, accounts receivable, etc. The core processes and your added value processes. Yeah? And this is also how we started. And then we decided, okay, let's start with our order to cash process because this was the process with the highest performance.
Highest performance, wow, yeah. So,
highest performance with regards to the rate of execution. So not the highest performance from quality perspective,
right?
Yeah. So,
it's the busiest,
process where you have the biggest leverage with regards to efficiency and effectiveness.
Right. I can imagine there's a lot of different things happening in a lot of different places that you need to see real time, too, from the supply chain side, from QA, from a lot of different things. Walk us through the process of how you brought in Celonis as a tool and where it's at now, what that evolution looks like.
Yeah. Here I need to talk about Celonis process mining on the one hand, but also about Celonis process management on the other hand.
I thought you might take us there.
Of course, it's my favorite topic because I talked about different information we have to manage our processes. We need to know where do we have to adhere to regulations, where do we have risks and controls, where do we have requirements from QM, etc. on the one hand. And this is what we manage with Celonis process management. So we document processes, and here we enhance our processes as with first operational data, standards, regulations, policies, risk controls, requirements, IT infrastructure, etc., etc. So here you get a really holistic picture about your process. Process mining, on the other hand, here you can reconstruct your processes based on digital footprints in IoT systems. So here you can gather information about utilization rates, automation rates, performance in general, cycle times, costs, of course, etc., etc. And if you bring both together, then you have a really holistic picture, and then you can make quite good decisions to manage your processes in the right direction.
How did you see, or what were you surprised by? Did you find any bottlenecks or inefficiencies when you started to look at this, and maybe in your supply chain or where?
Of course, I think quite often we try to look for the big opportunities to optimize the process. As we started and we connected our order to cash process, then we took a look at the process explorer. As you know, then you can push up sliders to add one variant after the next and one activity after the next, and then we saw a big spaghetti diagram. And this was really impressive because it's not about only one use case or one bottleneck. For me, the philosophy was to understand the whole process end to end first to do the right things right? And the big finding was, quite often it's not about the big thing you can optimize. It's about the many, many small things you have to re-engineer, you have to optimize, more or less in a continuous way. Yeah.
So this was more, you were able to see because it's more object-oriented and the processes are interconnected and you can see all of the different paths because, like you said, you know, quote to cash or order to cash, you're following the customer's journey once they've ordered it all the way to when they pay. Are there things that you saw that really surprised you with even your getting the materials? So there was like, was there any roadblocks in getting the product out to the customer or things of that nature? Or?
Of course, as I said before, I think the biggest challenge is that over the last decade in our digitalization journey, more and more processes disappeared in systems. So we have lost the big picture, right? What happens when I do something here, and what is the correlation to from order entry to logistics, etc.? And of course, we saw a lot of change activities and rework activities we weren't aware of. Yeah? And maybe sometimes you define a process on the one hand, and the question is, how can you control that you execute the process as the process is defined, right? And this is something you can demonstrate by Celonis process mining. Do you do the steps in the right order? Where do you have bottlenecks, rework activities, change activities, etc.? And this, of course, you need to reduce to become more efficient and effective, and to streamline your process and to reduce lead times, etc.
Were there any surprising discoveries that you can share with us when you went through this process?
I think the biggest surprise is quite simple. It was the number of variations.
Mm.
Yeah. So we had a lot of variations in our process world, depending on what employees do, because maybe different employees end on order differently. And you are not aware about this, because you cannot shadowing the employees the whole day. Yeah. And so this was quite surprising when it comes to variations.
How, when you started to roll this out, how did it go with people who were not in your part of the organization, so you're rolling it out so they get more visibility? How was the adoption, and how did they really take in on, hey, we've now modeled and we're managing this process, and here's the visibility into some of the bottlenecks that we're seeing for you. How were they taking that? Because it's the cultural, the people aspect, where maybe they're experts in their process, but this gives them a different level of visibility.
I think process management, in the end, is 70% people business, right? So, and people are quite different. So, such an overwhelming transparency can create fear. and uncertainty, of course. Yeah. So this here is quite important how you work with the employees and how you provide this transparency. And we are quite open. So we provide the transparency to the employees, and of course they shall use it to understand what they do. So, but in general, there is no black, no white. So it's from employee to employee quite differently. So some were really open and amazed, and they wanted to immediately start to optimize the process based on the information, because they thought they see a lot of opportunities, and some others maybe are more reluctant, because they have the feeling it's about controlling stuff. But this is not, that's an idea about process mining, because the people execute the process, of course, and maybe they have also lost the big picture over time when you grow and when you have global supply chains, correct? You have a manufacturing site, a logistics center here, and the administration part somewhere else. And so you lose the picture. And this is something we need to explain, we need to convince. And of course, a lot of people business necessary to bring people on board, to also to use it sufficiently.
What I'm hearing you talk about is the balance of trust and transparency with really the human psyche, which can be quite an adventure. And humans are usually the biggest variable in a lot of different systems. This might be a silly question, but I'm curious to hear your answer. How do you know which process or order of operations is best when you're looking at all these different ways that people are doing different things? How do you know which one to bring across the rest of the organization?
A quite important topic, especially when we talk about slowness in process mining. Let's take an example. Let's take an order to cash. So my first question is, has a company only one order to cash process? So for example, we have variations. We have rentals, loaners. We sell new things, new goods. We do services, etc. It's all about order to cash processes. And here again, Celonis process management comes into play. So the first thing you need to do, you need to architecture your processes, and that is something we do in our Celonis process management tool. And then we have set up the same architecture in Celonis process mining. So we avoid confusion, for example, to provide different views, different visualizations, etc., different terminology languages. To your point, with such an approach, you can also differentiate processes in a better way. Yeah. And then you can see, okay, where do I have my best practice process? For example, we have more than 40 sales sites across the world. That means we have an order-to-cash process in more than 40 sales sites. If you have an architecture where you can really concrete, visualize the process from site to site, and then you set up benchmark, then you can see, okay, where do I have best practices and where's worth to exchange ideas to bring this best practice to all the other subsidiaries and to learn from each other.
Yeah. I think one of the things that's really interesting is that process mining and process intelligence is really foundational, is data. And you have to have the right data to bring that in. One of the other things that goes along with that is AI. And being able to, are you guys exploring AI and using it at all with this process intelligence? Or
yes, we use AI for extended for process descriptions.
Okay.
Because when we talk about Celonis process management, one time-consuming topic is to describe processes and to model processes, and this is mainly done in a manual way. And of course, people are reluctant to do this. You have to model the process, and you have to enhance all the operational data. You have to do descriptions, and
it
so on and so forth. It's really time-consuming.
Yeah.
And here we use AI, for example. So also, we use AI to make descriptions. And in the future, we want also to use AI to bring operational data to the processes. So AI can recommend us, okay, maybe this policy applies to this process, but it's not met there. And there are some requirements in this policy you have to fulfill in this process. I can see this requirement in this process. This is a really, really cool thing. because for the time being, this is a really manual thing. And so one thing is, of course, to do it once manually, but you have to keep it up to date.
It's hard
day
to see
by
it.
Day. And this is about millions of relationships and mappings you have to do. And this is a really, really huge topic. Here AI can help as a quality manager, as quality assurance, to make sure that processes are up to date and adhere to regulations.
I think, yeah, that's an outstanding example. And what an efficiency gain. It lets you iterate on that over time quite quickly. Yeah, I can see all the advantages there.
And I can add something here, because as process management department, we ask our business to make their processes efficient. But as process management department, we have also our own processes.
Right.
And this process is really, really important to have efficient and effective business process management processes, because the information we provide is the value for our business to optimize their processes. That's why it's so extremely important to have this data and also supported by AI, so that we are able to provide this data day by day to our operations and business to streamline their processes in an efficient way.
It's almost a meta statement, right? You're using the process to make yourself more efficient, make the company more efficient. It's just a wonderful efficiency cake all around. Etienne, this has been a fantastic conversation. I have one more question for you. When we interview you this time next year at Next Celosphere, what do you hope to be able to say then that you can't say yet today?
I would like to talk more about integration of Celonis process management and Celonis process mining. So we have started this with Celonis, and we have generated a lot of great ideas, especially to increase the efficiency and effectiveness of process management itself. So I would like to talk more about this integration and how to exchange performance data from Celonis process mining with operational data we enhanced on our processes and our Celonis process management tool. And if we can bring those together, that's my dream for the next 2 years.
Well, I look forward to hearing about how you've achieved that dream and sharing that story next year. Etienne, thank you so much for taking the time. This has been lovely. Rob, as always, fantastic questions. And thank all of you for tuning in, wherever you might be on this beautiful rock. We're in Munich, Germany, day 2 of Celonis Celosphere. My name is Savannah Peterson. You're watching theCUBE, the leading source for enterprise tech news.